Have you ever seen DNA disappear? Well, today's your lucky day because I'm going to show you how over generations DNA actually disappears. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and today I want to show how recombining of DNA as it's passed down from generation to generation causes a loss of some DNA and why we see that when we actually look at the DNA files of different people. So we're gonna go over to GEDmatch. And GEDmatch is a free program. What is great about GEDmatch is that you can upload files from lots of different companies and be able to compare with everybody else that's on GEDmatch. And so if you have an ancestry file that you wanna compare to a 23andMe file, you can do that on GEDmatch. And that's what we're going to be doing here today. We have four people that we're going to be comparing. Now these first two that we're looking at is my grandfather and his second cousin. Well, we didn't know that they were second cousins until after they had both tested for DNA and they'd matched, and it helped solve a mystery, which I might tell you about another time. But if we're looking at the results of this, what we can see is we can see these blue sections where this is DNA that they match all the way. And so there's a little bit on chromosome 2, there's some on chromosome 4, and then some more on 7, and then on 10, you can see there's a lot on 10, a lot on 11, 13, we got more than half of the chromosome is the same that they share. And that's pretty common with second cousins, is you're gonna have lots of places where they match. Some more on 16, and then that's it. So these people match perfectly as far as second cousins go. But what happens with the next generation? Well, let's now look at this man named John York, who's a second cousin to my grandfather, and my dad is the son of my grandfather. So you'll notice it starts off being a little bit different. There is no match on chromosome number 2. That DNA from my grandfather that he shared in common with his second cousin has already disappeared in one generation. In other words, my dad inherited that segment of his DNA from his mom. He didn't inherit it from his dad. You can see on chromosome 4, that little segment is also gone. So already just in the first couple of chromosomes, we have the first two bits of match between my grandfather and his second cousin have disappeared. So it's a good thing that we have more than just four chromosomes. We get down to chromosome number 7, and there's a segment of a match. Let's look just a bit and let's compare. You can see that this is from location 91 million to 107 million with my grandfather. And with my dad, it's also that 91 million to 107 million. So it looks like that entire segment of DNA that he matches with his second cousin did get passed down to my dad. As we go down again, though, we get to chromosome number 10. Now remember, chromosome number 10 had quite a bit. It looks like almost half of the chromosome, and it's in two big chunks. One right here in the middle and then one on the end. But when we're looking at my dad, he didn't get that segment from the middle. All he got was that segment on the end. And that was from 126 million to 135 million. And over here you can see it's also that 126 million to 135 million. So that segment got passed down unchanged, but this segment was lost. We jump down now to segment 11, and you notice my dad didn't get any of it. Even though, again, it's almost half the chromosome in two big chunks. So my dad must have gotten at least this part of the chromosome all from his mom, my grandma. Now chromosome 13, this was more than half of the chromosome. You can see, again, big chunk here. And my dad, well, he got a big chunk, but you'll notice here that he didn't get all of that big chunk. He got from 45 million to 85 million, about 26.5 centimorgans. Whereas that whole segment was 52.7 centimorgans. So my dad only got about half of this segment, just half of it, from his father, which is what matches my grandfather's second cousin. So we can see all this DNA is disappearing as we go down in time. And then if we look, you'll notice that there's no more of those matches that my dad had. My grandfather still had one little segment on 16. So that's just one generation. We can see how that information of DNA has already been halved. Let's go one more generation and let's look at me. How much do I share with my grandfather's second cousin? Well, I couldn't share more than my father does because half of my DNA comes from my father and I can't get any more of it than that. We start and we go down and you'll notice, hey, these first 9 chromosomes, I have nothing that matches this man, Mr. York, which my grandfather had in chromosome 7. He had some in chromosome 4. He had some in chromosome 2. My dad had some in chromosome 7. So this part of my chromosome 7 didn't get it. I didn't get it. I got the part that my dad's mother gave to him, not the part that my dad's father gave to him, because it's not showing up here. If we go down now to chromosome 10, remember here, chromosome 10 had a big chunk, almost half of it, but my dad only got a small tail end of it. Well, I got a small tail end, but if you'll notice, I got from 128 million to 135, about 17.7 centimorgans, while my dad, he got 126 to 135, about 23.8, so he got a little bit larger. So the division, when that was passed down to me, that recombination actually happened just on this other side of this chromosome, which is pretty neat to actually see. So I only got a small segment of it. If we go down to chromosome 12, chromosome 13, my dad had a sum, but you'll notice I got nothing. I got a tiny little bit that says it matches in chromosome 11. But my dad doesn't have anything in chromosome 11. You'll notice my grandfather does have something in chromosome 11, and that's right in the right spot, 15 million to 19 million. 15 million to 19 million. So why, in this spot right here, does it not show any match between me and my dad? Well, that's actually for another video, but that can happen, and it's because of the processing that's being done and the inaccuracy in the algorithms that are used to actually match up your chromosomes. So after chromosome number 13, my dad doesn't have anything, which means I shouldn't have anything, and I don't. And so there's really just those two little bits that match with my grandfather's second cousin. So that is how DNA can disappear through the generations. You go from big chunks to little chunks to even littler chunks or no chunks at all. Thanks for watching Family History Fanatics. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below and we'll try to answer them for you.